take a few deep breaths. Inhale grace, exhale worry. With each breath, make yourself more aware of God's presence, right where you are. Today, on Good Friday, we take time to remember and reflect upon the sacrifice of Jesus. We recall Gethsemane. As Jesus, overwhelmed with sorrow, wrestled in the garden in prayer, asking God for another option, consumed with dread and anxiety for what was to come. Fully God, fully man, and yet yielding his will to that of the Father. Submission and surrender, total obedience, all in the name of love. Take time now to reflect on an area of life where God is asking for your surrender and obedience. Is there an area in your life that is yet unyielded? An area of your life where God is asking you to submit your will to that of the Father's? Together we pray. Lord, following the example of Jesus, today we surrender our will, our desires, our emotions. We lay down our own preferences, narratives, and agendas, and we ask for your will alone to be done in our lives. Holy Spirit, please reveal to us areas of our lives where we are holding on too tightly, and give us the grace and faith to release and follow fully in your way. Next, we recall the trials of Jesus, a mockery of justice, a charade of a court. Our sinless Savior sat quietly by as his accusers hurled fabricated allegations against him. He refused to defend himself. He refused to fight back. He allowed his name to be slandered, his character to be questioned, his ministry to be mocked. Like a lamb to the slaughter, he did not open his mouth. While every human instinct tends towards self-defense, Jesus instead chose self-denial. And with each of us in mind, he allowed for these proceedings to continue, uninterrupted and undisputed. Together we pray. Jesus, we consider with great gratitude and wonder the way you chose restraint in the face of false and humiliating accusations. You had every right to defend yourself, and you had every ability to make a case against your accusers. And yet, you chose not to engage. All for us. Thank you for your great love for us. We now turn our attention to the cross, the agonizing pain of nails hammered into flesh, the complete humiliation as onlookers cheered and jeered. Abandoned by his closest friends, betrayed by those he loved, fighting for breath, struggling to see, the God of the universe, the creator of the world, willingly submitting himself to utter torment, willingly succumbing to a humiliating death. How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only Son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss. The Father turns his face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold, the man upon a cross, my sin upon his shoulders. Ashamed, I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life, and I know that it is finished. Together we pray. Thank you, Jesus, for your unfathomable sacrifice for me that day. On this Good Friday, thousands of years later, we pause and ponder the magnitude of your sacrifice, the enormity of your pain, the agony of your humiliation. We are humbled by the reality that while we were yet sinners, you died for us. We were undeserving, and yet you still chose us.